Hello, Sandy Graham with HoboTraveler.com. I'm in Kiev, Ukraine. I've traveled nonstop for 16 plus years and went to 105 countries. 104 plus one rogue country, Transnistria. Okay, Steve asked, "Hey Andy, just got back from Staples here in Missouri. They did mine for only $265. He had his passport shrunk and made into a small passport. I have one in my bag here I always carry because I don't carry my passport with me. I probably can dig it out here. But, yeah, here it is. It's just a little thing with my picture on it, and it's made into a little thing. And I really, really recommend you do this because it almost serves as identification, though it's really not valid. Because they don't, you know, you're using it in a different country. They don't know what the United States gives us, right? Very cheap price for peace of mind and one step closer to get moving. How many copies of what documents would you recommend having handy for someone in traveler mode? I would recommend you have a couple validated or three, maybe what do they call them? Birth certificates. That's the document I really need. You need to take a picture of your passport, a picture of your driver's license, and any kind of medical stuff that you need, and take photos of it, send an email to yourself, write an email exactly to yourself, and then turn around and put it on a folder in like a free email account like Gmail or you know, Yahoo or Hotmail. Get rid of your Frontier or AOL or any of these accounts. Are really just dangerous to you because they're kind of, you know, you're not really traveling, you're just going on vacation. You're going to need, if you really did some extensive traveling, you're going to need a yellow fever thing. In some countries are now required an HIV thing, but you're most people are going to know way in advance on these things. But I carry around a yellow fever thing. I don't have a copy of it. I know I do have a copy saying by the World Health Organization that I don't need to get one every 2 years because it gets old. And because Brazil asked for a yellow fever shot. Most of Africa asked for it. 99% of you, no, 99.9, one in a thousand of you are going to Africa where you might need a yellow fever to get it. You really should take all your, you know, you got to be real careful on how you do it, but you should know all your numbers on your credit cards and get down to just two credit cards or two debit cards and not carry a whole list of them because that's just you volunteering to get robbed, so I don't, okay? But you need to know that. I always copy and paste my credit card number into a booking site. So let me read this again. How many copies of what would you recommend? So mainly you got the passport, your driver's license, which you're really not going to use, but it's nice to have. And then you really need to carry on you. I get a plastification of my, on the second or third page of your passport, you have to fill that out so that if somebody finds the passport or you get hit in a car accident, they know who to contact. And I also carry, the passport information gets old. So if you move a lot, like my address that I got when I got my 10-year passport, 9 years later is different, right? So actually, my mother and father used to do it. They used to take their name and address and make it into plastic, and then I would carry two or three of them, one in my backpack and one in my thing. And they just wanted it, if I got hurt, to know that who to contact. But those are the documents you really need. You're going to have to get good at being able to make copies on the road for airplane tickets. So those are other documents you need. But contrary to what you think, the e-tickets really don't work. You almost always have to print out the the email that you receive. Otherwise, you might not even get into the airport. There's airports that won't let you in there unless you show them that document. Okay, so yeah, you can check in without it, but you can't get inside the airport without it. So, but 90% of the stuff you can even do on the road. Now, when I say making a copy, a scanned in copy, you can actually take with a digital camera, you can take a photo, but be careful where you put this stuff because it does assist people in identity theft. And don't put it on Facebook or whatever. And when you're on Facebook, you know, don't say your birth dates and all these things because it's really too much information. Favorite colors. But I think I've answered most of the questions, but most of you are not going to need the yellow fever one.